After reading 21 chapters, you must have realized that the book of Leviticus is a handbook for the priests and Levites to guide the people to holy living. It seems to be written specifically to the Israelites in the Old Testament times and not for us. But when Jesus came, he made all those instructions relevant even for us today. Jesus transformed the ritualistic outward actions into spirit-led inward obedience, which is what God had intended it to be in the first place. Hi, I'm Stephen Chan, the group leader of Lover's Cell, and the title of my sharing today is Give God Worthy Offerings from Leviticus chapter 22. Now, in the second part of this chapter, God detailed his very exacting standards on what are considered as worthy and unworthy offerings. But for me, the most important instruction is this: do not bring shame on God's holy name, which is described in verses 31 and 32. You must faithfully keep all my commands by putting them into practice, for I am the Lord. Do not bring shame on my holy name, for I will display my holiness among the people of Israel. I am the Lord who makes you holy. God wants his people to be holy, just as he is holy. He says that when his people faithfully practice his commands, he will be glorified. On the contrary, if they do not, then his holy name will be shamed. Now, when I first read this book, I wondered how instructions on treating what is clean and unclean, on dealing with diseases, sexual integrity, and the conditions of animals being sacrificed can be relevant to me. I felt that those instructions were archaic, and moreover, they're impossible to fulfill nowadays. Then I received the good news that on my behalf, Jesus offered himself as a pure and unblemished sacrifice, making me totally accepted by Abba. When Jesus hung on the cross, not only did he remove my sins, he imputed righteousness on me and on you too. Therefore, I dare to believe that anyone who accepts Jesus as his Lord and Savior is accepted as pure and unblemished in God's eyes. That said, does it mean that we no longer need to make worthy and acceptable offerings to God today? In my opinion, that is the exact opposite. Because Jesus became the ultimate offering for me, I can now offer offerings that are worthy to Abba, not by my own strength, but through the righteousness of Jesus Christ. So, what is a worthy offering in today's context? As I pondered over this, I'm reminded of what the Lord said in Matthew chapter 5, verses 23 and 24, which is, so if you are presenting a sacrifice at the altar in the temple, and you suddenly remember that someone has something against you, leave your sacrifice there at the altar, go and be reconciled to that person, then come and offer your sacrifice to God. For me, this is a demonstrable action of what Jesus meant when he commanded, you must love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, and all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself. So the key thought for me is this, that whenever I love my neighbor as myself, my sacrifice of love is the worthy and acceptable offering to honor Abba. It does sound like a very tall order, and it is. That is why Jesus sent the Holy Spirit to be our helper. We can't do this on our own. So let us call upon the Holy Spirit to help us to give worthy offerings to God every day. Will you join me to pray now? Holy Spirit, we need your help. Whenever we struggle to keep and practice God's commands to live in holiness so as to honor Abba, give us the strength, ability, and willingness to obey. Help us to live in purity and obedience to Abba. And as we declare our dependency upon you, Holy Spirit, help us to live our life in holiness as a worthy offering to bring glory to Abba's holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you for joining me today, and take time to now to look at the application reflections prepared for you and your family. Have a blessed week ahead.